so please give us your attention while we walk you through this plane's safety features. Please hold on to safety features.
Okay, I don't know if you guys can hear me because I'm wearing my mask. I'm drinking mountain spring water. It tastes nothing like Zephyr Hills. My glasses are fogging up, but this is what I got. It's pretty good. I feel refreshed. And I got something to eat. I was being so picky because I'm like, bitch, I gotta wake up at 7 in the morning. But this is what I was actually craving on the plane, so. I was like, he gave it to me for $7 instead of charging the tax. It's the fog for me, but I'm gonna check in with you guys when I get to the hotel.
Oh my gosh, I didn't see that,
all
guys. I'm gonna turn my camera around.
Do you see? Oh, no, not my Tesla.
But I'm headed to the hotel.
Where's my camera?
I will show y'all the elevator, but you know, when you get off the flight, you don't really want to do all that. But this is the bathroom, and it's going to be my second camera. My girl got back camera troubles, but we got a bath. Is this the one? I think these, oh, these are fake fragrance free. So you know I'm about to be feeling very fancy. And this is me. And then we got our bathroom. Got a... Open door. I like that this has an actual door. I don't know if we have any doors there. Bathrooms, but this is, oh, this is probably a bad way to do it. Wow, this lighting is A1. I got two beds in here. I was supposed to have a roommate, but she got sick last minute, so the room is mine for now. Oh, look at the views. I don't even know. Oh, yeah, yes, crazy. Oh, the sun is coming out. Dang, I'm not alive. Can people see when? Oh, this is a parking garage. Oh, the sun is out. Now it's time to get, I'm trying to get some change back over here. Okay. The sun is out. I'm about to, I don't even know, because I don't want to lay. I need to close this blind. It's kind of making me a little bit paranoid. I need to, oh, let me show you the goodie bag. Y'all didn't see the goodie bag. You know, I got there and then they were like, goodie bag. So this is where we're at right now. Oh, I don't even know what this is. Okay, I'm just showing you guys what's in the bag. We got, you know how we do it. You know how we do it. Oh my gosh, CeraVe. Got moisturizing cream. I'm like so excited. Oh my gosh, skin caring. Okay, I'm excited to try all of these. Y'all, oh my god, they give me two. You know your skin needs it. Ooh, this is an oat gel moisturizer. I actually had used the oat cleanser by Aveeno and I enjoyed it. Let's see, skin fix. Oh my gosh, I have never felt so included in my life before. When you have eczema, the ostracization is like really crazy. Ooh, eczema therapy, daily moisturizing cream. And these are small little baby ones. I love it. I love it. I'm really loving this. Oh, this is another it's an oat gel moisturizer. Oh my gosh, recovery balm. Y'all, I'm about to have a review day. And then we got there's some pamphlets in here. Oh my gosh, these look so interesting. It looks like a lot of some medicines that you can, you know, decide to take. So these are some guides. I haven't read anything. I'm just literally going by this. What is this? Oh, this is a detergent pod. Okay. Purest wipes. I'm just, I'm just standing. That's why I'm like, wow, vlogging is a lot. And I need to take my hair out this ponytail because it literally hurts. But I got these. I'm going to go through all of these pamphlets. But the goodie bag is gooding. Skin Fix Targeted Body Balm. Free from steroids, antibiotics. We stand. Oh, this has shea butter in it. But I'm going to do a test patch, though, because baby, that's going to need to get it together. Do I still have heat bumps? I still have heat bumps. Okay. So, I'm going to go and, yeah, I'm going to take a shower because I've been up since 4:30 in the morning. Not even 4:30. 3.
Ah! It says my name on it! Guys. Do you not see that? My name is Jennifer.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I really hope that my neighbors cannot hear me because I just don't even got the time to mute my voice. You know how I do with boys. Okay. Oh my gosh. And I'll tell you, okay, I think my head is hurting because I literally have had this up in a ponytail since the day I freaking got it. And only because I was like nervous about, you know, me getting a reaction and stuff like that. Turns out I got a reaction from just sitting in the heat. And I don't think it was actually from the hair because I washed the hair, because my first reaction that I ever got was from braiding hair, which is usually synthetic, almost always synthetic. And I woke up with swollen eyes, but I will say I probably did still get a reaction, but it's kind of weird because, you know, when I was doing my hair at my cousin's house, then when I came home, like, the next morning, I had a swollen eye, which is the same thing that happened to me when I did my hair the first time, like, as a child, and realized, like, okay, girl, you got it. Your skin is sensitive. So then the next morning, after that morning, Saturday morning, if you hear this noise, it's me scratching. After that morning, I literally woke up with another swollen eye, and I had took some Benadryl and stuff, but right now I'm kind of having some heat bumps. You guys can't really see it. It's textured. Yeah, I got some heat bumps, so that's what I'm dealing with right now. So I am really... and I also have, I brought some stuff too, like, of course, I brought moisturizer and stuff like that. I usually use the Aveeno Daily Moisturizing Cream, the green bottle. I recently got the eczema one. Yes, this is the one I recently got, just in a bigger bottle. And, you know, I thought, okay, maybe I couldn't bring it because of the airport thing or whatever. So, yeah, I done gave myself a headache from that ponytail that's literally been in my head for since Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 5 days. I had a ponytail in my head. Like, that makes no sense. But yeah, I got these heat bumps. They're going wild. So I need to really just relax. I'm excited to be here. That's all I can say right now. I met Lauren. I was already emailing her, so I got to meet her in person. So Lauren, I met Susie, and then I just met another expo warrior. So yeah, I'm gonna get changed so I can relax because I had a long flight. Okay, I'm gonna try not to itch the bumps, but yeah. I will talk to you guys later. Oh my gosh, the sunlight, like, got me facing this way. Cause the spotlight ain't nothing without you, girl. Okay. God, I need to get into something in my head. Okay, so I have this big shawl. This shawl on. Because it looks super cute with this outfit. And I also told you guys I have the heat bumps. I just woke up not too long ago. I'm about to go get something from the market. I was going to walk to, it's called The Landing. But it's like 13 minutes away, 30 minutes technically for me to go there and back. And I was just like, look, I'm so tired, I'm going to have to pass. So I'm gonna go downstairs and get something to eat. Yeah, this is what I'm wearing right now. I'm looking crazy. I want you guys to see my extravaganza outfit yet. It's literally, I hung it up. I'm a person. I really saw under that camera yet. Oh yes. Oh yes.
There we go. All that control out.
Is this Saturday? Is this Saturday on your view?
Tomorrow, it's like 11:30 right now. I just made a TikTok with my little Goosebumps inspired night jammy. But this is what it looks like at night. The window's kind of hard glaring at that. This is the city. So I will show you guys what Expo is looking like tomorrow. I have volunteer hours that I have to do, so I have to be up at like 6 something. I start volunteering at 7. So talk to you later.
Good morning,
sir. And that's why you want to be a pharmacist. To
this feels so good. Oh, these are the cabanas. So where's the hiking? What is this? Oh, that's the airplane thing. Should have been an airport. Private dock. Oh, look at that.
It does. I did hear that. Must be true. I read it on the internet. Oh, mentions. Hi guys. Okay, so I know I have not been vlogging. Yesterday I just got so busy and I was having so much fun and I was like, if I bring my camera, I was like, how am I supposed to digest this information? But yesterday, what did I do? So I volunteered. I had volunteer hours at 7:30 in the morning. We did some volunteering, set up some tables, and then after that, I got some tea because they had a hydration station set up for us. So I'm gonna try to vlog some more today because today is officially when the expo starts. Yesterday was a soft opening. So today we're gonna have the general sessions, which I signed up for 4, and I have one breakout session that I'm gonna be doing, so I'm gonna try to get some footage in. But I just did yoga this morning and I feel super zenned out, and I think I'm gonna do it again. It was at 6:30 to 7:15, but it's like once I got out of bed, it was like, I'm not new to this, I'm true to this. But yeah, so I'm looking forward to doing that again, and I'm looking forward to the general sessions, because they're going to be so informal. And I think sometimes when you like have something firsthand to like hear the scientific facts behind it, and you know what you can actually do to apply it to your skin and stuff like that, it's going to be super fun. I'm looking so dry this morning, but yeah, you know, and I literally like put on some CeraVe before I left for my session and stuff like that, before I left for my yoga session and stuff, because I don't want my neck to like hurt. And
that. But you know when you take a shower, you got your the pores open. I just put it on like dry skin. So there's that. So my bed is not made. So yeah, I know you can see that in the background. But after that, I'm going to go get ready to go downstairs because they're going to do the opening session, which is from 9 to 9:30. We're going to have the CEO of NEA, National Eczema Association. I'm pretty sure she's going to do some speaking, give us like a little, probably a good little warm-up to do so we can all feel welcomed, even though like this is our safe space. So I'm excited to be here. And I just think that I was like nervous that I wasn't going to come anymore. And it just like feels so good to like meet people who literally understand what I go through. I've been meeting some great people. So yeah, yesterday, what did we do after volunteer hours? There was like two sessions that I attended. It was like journaling and stuff like that. So that was super nice. And then there was an ambassador intensive, which helped us like to, you know, help us advocate for our story better so that when we, you know, speak to other people that it's not all over the place. So that was a super fun exercise. And then they showed Jeremy's video, and I'm going to link it also in the description box so that way you can guys see it. Wow, I'm so dry. Okay. What's new? But yeah, Jeremy's video was super touching. I was like I'm not gonna cry at Expo. I knew I was gonna cry, but I didn't think it was gonna be like that soon. So I was just like, damn, they should have passed out some tissues, because his video was very moving and it just reminded me when I was in high school and I got my staph infection. And I was just like, I didn't think that I could get bacteria like on my arm from scratching so much. So I definitely understood exactly what he went through. So if you're interested in watching that video, which you should watch it, because it's very touching and it's just kind of like, dang, like we all really have this cycle of like that we go through, and it's just kind of like heartbreaking, but it's also just kind of, there's this like inner warrior in you that is like, yo, I survived it. And it's just kind of like, it's just like, you know, I think sometimes I just go, I don't want to start crying on camera and stuff like that, but it's just like really, it's just like, wow, like, and especially when you know you've been, you know, suicidal and stuff like that over your skin, it's just like, wow, like, I really got over that hurdle, and I think that is something so big. So if you're going through skin issues right now, trust the process and just write out your emotions. I know that sometimes, like, I just brought up suicide, so it's very, like, your skin can really make you start thinking like that, and you don't ever want to get to that place. You know what I mean? Like, we're here for you, and that's why I like this community is growing so, so much bigger, and I'm really happy to be a part of it, because for a long time I felt so alone. And you know, it's just kind of like crazy, because it's almost like when you have eczema, like it's almost like you're literally the one in three people that have it. So it's just kind of like you could be in the classroom and it's just you, and then like no one else has it. So it's just kind of like you have no one else to relate to, and then you could be the first person in your family to have it. But it's actually amazing to see the warriors unite and actually like make that breakthrough and stuff like that. So yesterday was super fun. I'm going to go ahead and get ready, try to get some more footage and stuff like that. Oh my gosh, we did karaoke. How did I miss out on the best part? We had Jennifer and the Fivettes, even though I think it was like six of us up there. We did All I Want for Christmas. So I'm going to insert some, you know, snippets of that in there. And it was so fun because I was just kind of like, I love it here. I don't want to leave on Sunday. I mean, if we all decide to not leave the hotel room, can they kick us out? Just kidding. But yes, BRB. So I'm going to go get ready because I only got like 15 minutes, but yeah, I'll be down there in a jiff, so talk to you guys later. Okay guys, I am back in my, oh gosh, I need to not crash out of habit. So I'm back in my hotel room. I just came from a hike. Today has been a very busy day, but I'm headed to the extravaganza. So I just came to check in with you guys, just so you can, I'm gonna kind of show you a little bit of me getting ready. And then after that, we're gonna show you what the turn up is looking like. So yeah, I've just been like, it's been kind of hard to vlog because it's like when you're literally in the moment, it's just like, how can I pull my phone out? You know, you're making all these connections. So it's just been like super great. Like I have not even been like posting any hashtags, which kind of sucks because I don't think I'm gonna win they're doing like a giveaway for you being like really active, but you know, it's like a scoreboard thing that they're doing on the Eczema Expo 2022 app. But yeah, I got my
ambassador shirt. And if you have eczema, you need to join and become an ambassador today. But yes, so I'm going to get ready and then I will be right back with you.
Okay, so I decided to kind of just do a little thing. It's gonna be ran through, but I just literally kind of have a conversation with myself, and I kind of wanted, there's like so many different sessions that I've been going to, and they've just been like super insightful and stuff like that. And I think what's been super insightful for me is when I had joined the NEA research journal, and I had, you know, they were talking about like the microbiome and like pregnancy and probiotics, and you know, women taking probiotics, like do they see less risk for their child while they're taking probiotics and stuff like that. So I think it was just like so dope to kind of like get an understanding of that, because it was like I had never even thought about like taking probiotics. Like, you know, I had literally researched everything in the freaking land, so it's like pretty crazy that I had never like stumbled upon that and stuff. And I was like, oh my gosh, you know. And there's like different research studies and stuff like that. So I think for the most part, if I'm doing my graduate, like, girl, what the hell are you doing? Don't mind me, my sister usually does my makeup, so I'm just going with what I know. But yeah, so it's just been like, and then today we were in a session, and there was Dr. Ian Miles who was there, and then a lot of other doctors too. And they were talking about how, like, you know, smoking definitely affects the child. And you highly, you know, those people usually have an increased risk of having eczema. And I think about like how my dad used to smoke. And I remember when I got my first allergic reaction, I was doing my hair out on the porch, and that's where he used to smoke. I don't remember him smoking while I was doing my hair, but the next morning I woke up, I had inflamed eyes, and we were just like, I'm allergic to the weave, and I have these faux locks in right now, and I was getting like really worried. And I'm not gonna lie, I did wake up and I did have some inflamed eyes, like my eyes were swollen, and it was just kind of like crazy, because what I think really kind of struck out for me was the fact that, like, in Dr. Ian Miles' session about the microbiome, it was kind of like Lubiderm was on there as, you know, not friendly to your microbiome and the skin. And I had used Lubiderm, and then I also had used the Aveeno eczema therapy on my skin, because I was like, okay, let me stop using the Lubiderm because it's clearly something that my skin don't like in it. And I only didn't buy the colloidal oatmeal one because I just did not see it at Family Dollar and stuff like that. So it was kind of like just really eye-opening, I would say. And I've just been honestly kind of just like, wow, just learning so much today. I just kind of wanted to share that quickly with you guys, because I'm like, you know, women are born with two generations in their ovary eggs, and my mom, I'm the only one in my family, like the first to have eczema and stuff like that. My mom doesn't have eczema, my sister doesn't have eczema, but my niece has eczema. So it just, you know, it makes you wonder. It's just like, it's kind of crazy. It's a lot, guys, and it just makes me feel like we gotta really all take our health super serious and stuff like that. And hearing these researchers talk about it, and you know, obviously put it into, I guess, English terms and basic terms for us was very, very insightful and stuff like that, and it was super good. So for me, it was just kind of like, I am just enjoying this so much and stuff. So I just wanted to share that quick little thought with you guys. So I will be right back. For the most part, we're all kind of going early. Like, it's an extravaganza. The stars do not show up until the show really starts, and the show doesn't start until the stars show up, and we are all stars here. So I'm just gonna finish my makeup. Y'all call that girl, you ain't even did your brows, but anyways, it's how I like them. Next. Talk to you later. I'm food, but where is it? Hold on. Okay.
Just finished. I feel like I'm slurring my words because my feet freaking hurt. Y'all see the fit. Anyways, I had such a good time. Like, I could cry. Like, I could literally cry. I thought somebody saw my pictures, but they were all stuffed together. So this is the outside view. Everybody is kind of figuring out. I just literally made myself walk, knowing damn well my feet is hurting. Like, how am I gonna make it to the end? This is the views that I got right now, y'all. My baby, my oh, there's people kayaking at this time. Oh shit, you can go out here now. Oh my gosh, you guys can't even see anything. I'm over here like trying to show y'all. This is the city you never see. My baby pretty face, you know how to everything. On the poetic justice in Seattle. This is the views I got right now, y'all. And the blue lights are shining. My heart's, oh shit, my heart's still ignited. Can I get that? Everybody's here, everybody's inside and I'm outside. I was just getting some air. I just met, oh fuck. I'm kind of drunk, y'all. But yeah, we were just talking, and it was super, super, super sweet. He's so funny. He was like, he kind of actually doesn't like the fact that Expo only talks about eczema and stuff like that. But it's like so cool to like kind of learn about what's going on in your body. So yeah, I've just been meeting some wonderful people, and I'm just like, I'm doing it. Like, I'm literally doing it, and that's what's making me the most happy, is that I'm not allowing my suffering to be my excuse for not doing things. And I'm not saying that if you're suffering, I ain't gonna lie, I don't care. I just simply feel like if you're suffering, you have to kind of go through that roller coaster. Like, I don't believe in faking, you know, it's not necessarily faking the funk, but I don't believe in forcing yourself to do something that your heart is not all the way in. Like, if you're literally healing, like, your heart may not be in the right space to pursue something and put your all into it. You're focused on your health, and there's nothing wrong with that. I'm having like drunken thoughts, so there's that. But I leave tomorrow. I don't want to go. I knew I should have stayed an extra day, but it's okay. But yeah, like, we're just all kind of outside of the lobby. Like I told you, I'm outside, and everybody's inside. They're playing games and stuff. I'm gonna head inside because it's not even that cold. I was thinking about getting up for yoga. It's like 12 now. Yoga is at 6:30. Like, shit is kind of mad. And I'm like, I gotta pack my bags or whatever. But yeah, I didn't even see when Andrea left. Tonight.
We wear